Okay, student. Now the next topic is the geometrical meaning of angular momentum. It is very important topic, geometrical meaning of angular momentum. What is the geometrical meaning? Here the angular momentum magnitude is, mod mein likhna hai, this is magnitude, is twice the mass of the body into dA into the product of, or you can say that the magnitude of aerial velocity. What is this? This is called as aerial velocity. Students, you know simple velocity, you know angular velocity. Angular velocity is rate of change of angular displacement. Here it is aerial velocity. Aerial velocity means rate of change of area. Rate of change of area. When area changes with time, then the velocity is said to be aerial velocity. Right? Now to prove this, we have to prove it. Right? To prove karne ke liye, let us suppose this is a coordinate system. X-axis and this is y-axis and this is z-axis. A particle is moving in xy plane. Ek particle hai, kaun se plane move kar raha hai? Xy plane mein, right? At any about this z-axis. Let us suppose that at any instant the particle is at point K. A isliye nahi lenge kyunki hum A aerial velocity ke liye use kar rahe and its position vector is r. This is at time t. Now after time dt, it reaches to the new position. Let us suppose it is s. This is at time t and this is at time t plus dt. Right? And what is its position vector? R plus delta r, or you can say it is dr. Right, student? So you will do here it in step. What is the displacement of the particle? This is starting point and this is final point. So you can join it. Right? Now I will calculate k to s in triangle OKS. What is that? I apply triangle law of vector addition. OK plus KS is equal to OS. What is OK? This is vector R. What is KS that we want to find out? This is R plus DR. So what is KS? This is equal to R get cancelled out and this is equal to DR. So this is the displacement of the particle. This is the displacement of particle or change in the time interval, in the time interval dt. Is it clear, student? This is the change in the position of the particle in the time interval dt. Now we have to calculate what is the area covered, area swept, kyunki yahan aerial velocity ki baat aa rahi hai. So I will use here what is the area covered area covered in the time dt. Now, I will complete here this parallelogram. I will draw a vector parallel to this. Let this vector is O to M. This is parallel to this one. Complete it. Right? Now, I will calculate area covered by this is area covered by the object or area swept bhi likh sakte. Area covered by the object in the time interval dt. ठीक है, तो dA क्या होगा? This is equal to area of triangle OKS. Area of triangle OKS. और ये क्या होगा? ये हमने बेटा cross product का significance करा था. If there are two vectors, they are represented by the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram. Then what is the area of parallelogram? This is equal to, अगर ये vector A है और ये vector B है, तो area of parallelogram क्या होगा? This is mod of A cross B. तो हमें चाहिए, this is area of triangle, so this is half of, what is this side? This is dr, because it is parallel to this one dr. Half of, this is area of parallelogram, OKSM. Right, this is the half of, एरिया ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम ओके एस एम. और हम एरिया ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम कैसे निकाल सकते हैं? जिसकी एक एडजेसेंट साइड आर है एंड सेकेंड इज डी आर. दिस इज मोड ऑफ आर क्रॉस डी आर. दिस इज द एरिया स्वेप्ट. नाउ डिवाइड बोथ द साइड्स बाय डी टी. सो इट बिकम डी ए बाय डी टी इज इक्वल टू हाफ ऑफ आर क्रॉस डी आर अपॉन dt. What is dr upon dt? It is velocity, r cross velocity v. नाउ वी कैन राइट दिस एज पी क्या होता है आपका एम इन टू वी, लीनियर मोमेंटम इज मास इन टू वेलोसिटी, तो आप वी को क्या लिखेंगे, दिस इज पी अपॉन एम, सो दिस इज हाफ ऑफ मोड ऑफ आर क्रॉस पी अपॉन एम, सो दिस बिकम हाफ ऑफ आर क्रॉस ए पी, एल इज इक्वल टू अभी हमने पढ़ा क्या है आर क्रॉस पी, तो दिस इज एल अपॉन एम, सो स्टूडेंट वी हैव डन इट, दिस इज एल इज इक्वल टू मोड टू एम इन टू डी ए बाय डी टी, इट इज द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ट्वाइस ऑफ मास एंड द एरियल वेलोसिटी. I think it is clear to all of you. In first step, what you will do, you will find at any time the position of particle is k, after time t plus dt it is at s. So in time dt, what is the position it gets changed? Dr, complete this parallelogram. You have to find the area covered. Area covered is area of triangle OKS. And this is the half of area of parallelogram OKSM. Or area of parallelogram ke liye, we have used the significance of cross product. Significance of cross product. So here the parallelogram adjacent sides are R and DR, right? So its cross product is R cross DR mode. Divide both the side by DT. So DR upon DT is velocity. And from here you can write velocity as P upon M and it is L upon M. I think it is clear to all of you. Now the next topic is the equation of motions. Next topic is equation of motion in rotational motion. Equation of motion in rotational motion. Student, no need to do its proof. These equation of motion are same as which we have already discussed in unit 2, rotational motion for uniformly accelerated motion. Uniformly एंगुलर एक्सेलरेशन, इट हैज यूनिफॉर्मली बिकॉज रोटेशनल मोशन है तो यूनिफॉर्म एंगुलर एक्सेलरेशन है, एल्फा इज कॉन्स्टेंट, ठीक है, राइट. तो अगर हम बात करते हैं एंगुलर वेलोसिटी की, हियर थीटा इज द एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट, वॉट इज ओमेगा, ओमेगा इज एंगुलर वेलोसिटी, एंड वॉट इज दिस, दिस इज डी थीटा अपॉन डी टी, रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ एंगुलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट, वॉट इज एल्फा, एंगुलर एक्सेलरेशन, इट इज डी ओमेगा बाय डी टी, रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ एंगुलर वेलोसिटी. जैसे हमने लीनियर मोशन में क्या पढ़ा था, लीनियर मोशन में हमने पढ़ा था डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज एक्स और दिस इज नॉर्मल डिस्प्लेसमेंट, वी इज द वेलोसिटी, लीनियर वेलोसिटी एंड इट इज डी एक्स अपॉन डी टी, वॉट इज एक्सेलरेशन, दिस इज ए इज द एक्सेलरेशन एंड इट इज डी वी अपॉन डी टी, रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ लीनियर वेलोसिटी. ये लीनियर मोशन में है और ये किस में है, रोटेशनल मोशन. अब फर्स्ट इक्वेशन हमने वहां क्या करी थी, v इक्वल टू यू प्लस ए टी. अब रोटेशनल मोशन में क्या हो जाएगी, इन रोटेशनल मोशन इट इज ओमेगा इज इक्वल टू, फाइनल वेलोसिटी इज दिस, तो हियर फाइनल एंगुलर वेलोसिटी इज ओमेगा, इनिशियल एंगुलर वेलोसिटी इज ओमेगा नॉट, दिस इज एल्फा इन टू टाइम, दिस इज फर्स्ट इक्वेशन ऑफ motion. Second equation of motion is s equal to ut plus half a t square. So here you will get s as theta is equal to omega naught into t plus half of alpha into t square. Student, no need to do its proof. Third equation of motion is v square minus u square is equal to 2as. So this is omega square minus omega naught square is equal to 2 into alpha into theta. So we have discussed three equation of motion. Alpha is the angular acceleration. So in the next lecture, we will discuss the numerical on it. Thank you. Have a nice day.